Hey guys, my name is Cynthia, this is Tiny Tech Talks, and today I'm going to walk you through my process of going from a mockup to a WordPress website using the Oxygen Builder. So first things first, let's start off with the mockup. It's a very simple design. We just have a hero section with a little menu. Next up, we kind of have like a contact us section. We have a who are we section, and then we kind of got like our services or packages. And a little footer. All right, so let's head over to WordPress. Okay, so I already went ahead and installed a fresh WordPress install. I did already upload the media files we were going to use. I've also created a homepage, which is set as the front page, which is still a blank page at the moment. And I've also went ahead and already installed the Oxygen plugin as well as the Hydrogen plugin, which basically adds a few neat features to Oxygen. It's definitely not needed, but I do like some of the stuff it provides. So let's go ahead and go into Oxygen, and we're going to start off with creating a template. Now, technically, this is not really necessary as it's just a one-page website at the moment. However, it might become a multi-page in the future. And by already creating the template right now, it will help us if we ever have the need to expand this website. So let's add a new template. I'm going to call this main, as this will be our main template that holds the header and the footer. I'm going to go to other, and we're going to set it to catch all so that this is the default template for every page we create. So let's publish that one, and then let's go into edit with Oxygen. Okay, so the first thing I want to do is add some global colors and change the font that is being used as a default font. So I'm going to go into settings and then global styles. Let's first add some colors. I'm going to add this to the global color set, and I'm going to head over back to XD, and I'm going to input all of these colors. So I have added the three normal colors, but if you go into XD, you can see that there is a slight transparency on this one, and as you can see, it's about 80%. So let's copy over the hex code, add this as a color, let's call it overlay, paste in the color, and then we can go ahead and set that transparency to 80, just like the mockup. So now that we have our colors in here, it's time to set up our fonts. So let's go back to our global styles, then head into font, and let's see which fonts are being used. So it's Open Sans for both, so let's set the display font to Open Sans as well as the text font. So both of them now have Open Sans as their default. So let's save up. And then there's one thing that you actually can still change, and that's the page setting, and that's the page width. Now I like the default page width that Oxygen provides, but if you want to have a specific page width, you can definitely set that up right in here. Okay, so let's design this header section. So first thing you want to do is add a section, and we're going to set the background image as well as the overlay. So as you can see, it's quite small, so let's go to size and spacing, set this to view height, let's try 75. That looks quite nice. Now the only other thing I want to do right here is decrease this padding, because it's way too big, as I want my menu to be closer to the top. So let's set this to 24 pixels. All right. So now you want to add the menu. Now Oxygen has some built-in elements. However, this time I'm actually going to use a div with some text links, as I want to do like an anchor type of link where it scrolls down to the section. So let's start by adding a div, and let's position it to the right. So let's go into advanced size and spacing and set the margin to auto, which pushes it to the correct site, and then let's add a text link. Now I wanna add some style to this, so I'm gonna add a class called menu link to this one, and then let's set the text color to like the light gray color, and then the hover can be like the orangey red color, like that. That's perfect. So let's input info. Now as you can see, there's no padding or no margin applied, so let's fix that. So let's put a margin of 12 pixels on both sides, giving it a bit more space, because we actually want to duplicate this one a few times so that we have the three options. As you can see, this is stacked incorrectly, so let's set it to horizontal, and then let's change it to the correct text. There we go. So far, that's everything we want to do for this menu. We will input the URLs later on. So next up is our logo. So let's go to add. Let's make sure we are in our section. Let's go to add image and let's browse, check out the logo. As you can see, it's not the best quality logo, so make sure if you are designing for a client that you get a good quality version of their logo or any other images that you need to use on their website. Now let's position this in the middle, so let's go to size and spacing and set all of these to auto so that it is centered in the middle. So the next part we wanna build is our footer. So now before we're gonna build our footer, I'm actually gonna already insert the inner content element, which we will use to display the other sections. So now we got our header section and inner content, and then below that we are gonna add another section, which is gonna be our footer. So let's take a quick look at that design. So it's the dark blue background, and then it has like three columns. So first things first, again, let's set the background color to our dark blue. That already looks quite nice. So now I actually wanna go ahead and add some columns, which in our case will be three. And then the first column will contain, as you can see, just the logo. So let's quickly add that one. So let's go and add a image. Again, let's add the logo. So select this one. As you can see, it's way too big, so let's make it a bit smaller. Next up, let's take a look. I'm actually gonna do this one first because it's quite easy. Okay, so let's get into this section. So first thing I wanna do is add some text. So let's add a text, let's make it a paragraph. I'm actually gonna apply a class to it because I might wanna reuse this styling later on. So I'm gonna call this footer title. I'm gonna set the text color to the gray one, and I actually wanna make it a slightly more bold, so I'm gonna put a font weight of 600 on that. Now let's head over to our mockup and copy the text. So let's put that in. That already looks quite nice. So now let's add the other text field, which I'm also gonna make a paragraph. Let's quickly copy over the text so we can see what's happening. I'm also gonna put a class on this one, so I'm gonna call this footer text. Let's add that. Set the text color to our gray. Now as you can see, since I made it into a paragraph, it already has a margin on the top and the bottom, so I wanna actually get rid of that. So I'm gonna get rid of the top margins by just putting 0 pixels on both of these elements. Now I also want to change the font weight of this one because I think it's a bit too heavy, so let's put it on 200. Now let's see how that looks. That looks quite similar to our mockup. So the only thing that is left is adding our icon, which is a social icon. So I'm just gonna use this element that is already in Oxygen. Let's take out Twitter and Instagram because we only need Facebook. Now let's reduce the size to like 24 pixels, then set the icon color to our gray and the icon hover color to our red. So let's see. All right. Now for the middle section, I am gonna start off by adding a div, and then inside that div, I'm actually gonna add an icon. I'm gonna give it the correct color. And let's reduce this to like 32. I also prefer the linear icons over the font awesome icons. So let's use whatever they have. Perfect, that already looks quite nice. And then I'm also gonna add another div. And as you can see, these are stacked incorrectly. So let's put it horizontally. And then inside this div, I'm gonna add a text field, and this is where that class comes in handy we made before. So I'm just going to use that footer title to make this bold text. There we go. And then I'm also going to add another text field, and I'm going to use the other footer class we made before. Let's copy over the information. Now this already looks quite good, but there are a few things that I still want to change. First things first, let's give this icon a bit of a margin. Let's put 24 pixels. Okay, that looks quite nice. And then the other thing I want to do is actually I want to middle align these. Yep, I'm happy with this one. So I'm gonna actually copy this entire div, or duplicate this entire div, and let's change it to the correct information. So let's grab this text, put it in here. We can delete this text field, we don't need it. And let's change that icon to a phone. Oh, I actually like this one a lot. Or we can maybe use this one. No, let's use that one. All right, and then duplicate this once more. And grab the information, put it in here, and change the icon again. All right, now to get this aligned a bit more nicely, I'm actually gonna go into our main div, set it to vertical, and then set it to space between, which spaces them out evenly between the top and the bottom. So this looks quite nice. I'm quite happy with this. Last thing I want to do is actually decrease the padding on this section a little bit. So let's go into size and spacing, and let's set this to 32 pixels top and bottom. That looks a lot better. So let's save this. And now we have created our header and our footer. So next up will be the inner content, but that will be in part 2 of this video series. So stay tuned for part 2, where we finish up this mockup.